For a deaf child entering the community today, it's a completely different experience. That first generation, they were languageless and they had to figure out on their own how to communicate with each other. And yet a child today, there's a full developed language around them that they can learn immediately. My research focuses on a new sign language that's been emerging in Nicaragua within the deaf community there. It started in the 1970s. Over the course of the last 40 years, the language has blossomed and grown and emerged. For a scientist like myself, this is an unprecedented opportunity. It's the only case that we know of a language that's been documented while its originators are still alive. I've been documenting this language since 1990. I go down in the summers, and I'll bring a small research team with me, including some Barnard students, and we'll videotape different people in the community in a way that lets us capture how the language changed over time. We bring that video back, and analyzing this video is kind of like code breaking. We're trying to figure out what the regularities are. I look at every generation of the language as it got passed down to new waves of children each year. What we've learned by studying the emergence of this particular language is that all languages come from the same place, and that's from child learners. That children have a special capacity not just to learn language well, but to create and organize and change language over time. Barnard has provided opportunities for students to be able to work with me. For example, I've had some students do summer research institute fellowships or independent studies, and this makes it possible for me to build a research team where they're not just learning from me, but they're also mentoring each other. As long as I've been doing this work, I'm always excited to study Nicaraguan Sign Language. It gives us this opportunity to take a snapshot of the creative power of the human mind.